series is Exuberance by Brant, Karrick from Northern Kentucky University. It's about a teacher in Ohio. It was written in memory of a teacher in Ohio that was lighthearted, fun, a military veteran, and also a man of faith. So you might have heard of all thousands of times say that they're all over the Charles Wesley was living throughout the piece. So prominent in many ways in the middle of the change of form. We're going to go on now with the IM, Andrew Boysen Jr. And this piece was about a baritone saxophone player in the band Cedar Rapids, Iowa, who passed away. And he was a high school student at the time, so I thought it would be very appropriate for our experience when we're trying to be here and things that are meaningful and memorable. And the piece features very saxophone quite a bit. Has a section that's aleatoric, which means that there's prescribed things for musicians to play, but it's different every time they play it, and it's over a period of time instead of conducting through measures. You'll hear that. It's supposed to depict the fog before the crash that happened. The limbs, the baritone section for the simple crash. He wrote a poem, this young man wrote a poem a couple of days, about a week before his death. And that's what inspired the composer to write this. And I wanted to read the poem to you. This is from Lynn Jones, January 1990. So give you perspective, he'd be somewhere around 46 or 50 years old. I am life, music, competition. I like exciting things and doing good for others. Beauty, successfulness, and smartness are important. I like to achieve recognition. I can succeed if I really put my mind to it. I am very set in my ways, but I can change when I realize my ignorance. I like a simple, nonchalant lifestyle. I hate ignorance. I hate structuredness. This is me. I am. That was the title of this poem, I am. This is the title of the composition, I am, by Andrew Boysen Jr.
Thank you. formal picture of students on stage. I want to make sure we don't have anything in the audience in the way of pictures. So if we can find a place to sit tight just for about 15 seconds, that would be wonderful. Students, you understand something for a minute. Let's give us about 15 seconds. Dr. Bessel's up off stage. Thank you for that. Give us a round of applause. We're going to play chairs and let you move out for you. Thank you all. Next up, we have students who are in our blue honor band. And the blue honor band has had the privilege of working with Tremon Kizer the next 2 days, or the last 2 days. Maybe the next 2 days will be Brian. So I'll be good about it. Other guys have done service from Orlando, Florida. He's currently the Associate Director of Bands and Director of Athletic Bands at the University of Central Florida. And also, as I just learned a couple days ago, he's the new Assistant Director of the School of Music there with a recent promotion. So congratulations on that. Our guys have degrees from Kansas State University, University of Central Missouri, and University of South Carolina. Barbara worked at the University of Central Florida, and he was teaching at the University of Dayton, so he's been in the region at some point. You can read his bio that his band has played in numerous places, and most recently at UCF, March Humanity the Rights has been playing in numerous bowl games, and they've seen an enormous decrease. They now have over 420 some members in the March Humanity at the University of Central Florida. To say that Dr. Kizer is energetic would be an understatement of the century. I think he sleeps with caffeine in his veins. And they have had a wonderful time. He makes my antics look a little calm when my students. Without any further ado, would you please welcome the outstanding students of the Blue Honor Band and their conductor, Dr. Tremon Kizer.
Here we go. Ready? Thank you. on from there to become the Associate Director of Bands at the University of Alabama. The Georgia Bulldog made me forgive for that. Great loss. After a long, successful tenure at Alabama, he moved to his present position where he is the Director of Bands at the University of Tennessee in Chattanooga and has been fantastic work building that program at UTC. He also directs a professional group, semi-professional group, runs the Alabama Bands, consisting of adults and music educators, and they rehearse once a week and recently received a performance at the prestigious Midwest Band Clinic in Chicago, when honored with an invitation to perform at that national, international event, actually. He's also an elected member of the American Band National Association, a very prestigious honor in our profession, and he's currently serving as the president of the National Band Association, the largest organization for band directors in our country. Please join me in welcoming the fantastic students of the Mount Hermon Honor Band and their conductor, my friend, Randall.
Thank you all.